Last year, around this time, I was on a real Michael Pollan kick, or crush. He's a writer. He's a foodie. He's a health nut. And I love the guy. I really love what Michael Pollan has to say. And yet, this year, I became deeply concerned about rigid rules surrounding how we eat, and thus recent episodes on organic produce and clean eating, and how to learn whether or not you may need to seek counseling. So with that in mind, I decided to go back through For the Health of It episodes, and yet again, in one of them, I made a statement that I just don't think I believe any longer. So I'm here to set the record straight. It's not food if it was created in a plant. Oh, good grief. I really do understand the thought behind that statement. I call it the Twinkie effect, referring to foods that are magically produced in a plant by way of a chemical reaction of sorts. They can actually live for years, which means, okay, they don't contain whole food ingredients. The advice behind this catchy phrase is something I totally agree with. It's really just encouraging us to eat less processed foods and increase the amount of whole foods that we consume. And I am 100% behind that. But I quibble with the phrase. It's a little too black and white. Is something really not a food if it was created in a plant? By definition, food is any nutritious substance that people or animals eat or drink, or that plants absorb in order to maintain life and growth. Well, I looked in my pantry, and while no, we don't have a ton of processed food, there are items in there that were made in a plant, and even so, they are still nutritious, and they are providing life and growth. I looked at some of the foods in my kitchen, and sure enough, several of them were made in a plant. These taco shells, made in a plant. This bread, made right in a plant. How about some hummus? Made in a plant. Spaghetti sauce? Made in a plant. And this item, a green salad? Made in a plant. And don't forget this bar, because guess what? It was made in a plant. Okay, all joking aside, I understand the caution that this statement is making. But to say it's not a food if created in a plant is just a bit of a stretch for me, and I'm sorry I led you astray. I still love Michael Pollan. I'm still gonna read him. I still love what he has to say. But guess what? Even my favorite meal replacement shake was created in a plant. And I'm gonna still keep drinking it for the health of it. Plant. Plant, plant, plant.